Our new sharpening system can also be used to sharpen square graver blanks. Cool. There's just a little adjustment that you have to do so that everything lines up. What I like to do is to, first of all, put the set screw on a flat side of the graver blank, then decide which side, which angle here is going to be the top. I like to take a Sharpie and run it down there just so that it's very clear what the top of the tool is intended to be. In this case, I have the set screw coming in at the right side as I'm looking at it, the left side as you're looking at it, to the square part of the graver. Now I'm going to also use the 55 degree face because that's my preference. So normally, if we were dealing with the round blank, I would have the set screw straight up and it would be, or straight down rather, and it would be exactly opposed to the middle three index slots. However, because it's at a 45 degree offset, given that the square, with a square blank, we can't put the set screw on one of the edges very well because it will shift. So we want to rotate that 45 degrees and have the set screw come in on one of the flat sides. And in this case, again, I picked on the right-hand side of the graver as I see it. When we go to put it into our face fixer, I want to make sure that the part that I have designated as the top, which I have marked with the Sharpie, is going to be straight down. So to look at the index slots and the tangs, now I have rotated this graver in the collet to the left. So we are in index slot 1, 2, and 3, as opposed to being in the middle slots. And when I push that in, push the collet in, and I put the face angle geometric block in there and I put it down, I can look at it before I commit to anything to make sure that the side that I expect to be down, which again is marked with the blue Sharpie, is actually down. And it is. Okay, so I'm gonna start on the 260 block here with this square graver blank. About halfway through now. That was the 260 wheel. Now I'm going to step down to 600 and then to 1200. Okay, now we have a perfectly level plane of 55 degrees on the face of the graver. The next part is to shape our 105 on the square graver blank. So we take our 105 parallel with the 55 degree face that we just put on it, and we work on the shaping areas, which are the two top holes. So if I take the graver as I would use it and look down on it, I can move it slightly to the right and line it up. In this case, we would want to rotate it to the right so that the first three holes for index slots are taken up by the three tangs. Once it's lined up, you push it right in. Again, it's always a good idea to put it on there and visually inspect to make sure it's what you think you're doing. In this case, I'm going to use the 600. Okay, I have the right side of the tool shaped. Now we're going to do the left side of the tool. So we put the graver in, we move it towards the left. And we make sure that on the right side, the first three index slots are taken up by the tangs. And then we push it in. Again, always a good idea to put it on the wheel without anything moving and to look at it to make sure that it makes sense with the place that you're going to grind. Now we have a 105 degree body shaped on this square graver. We've now finished shaping the body for the 105 degree parallel graver. The next thing to do is to put the parallel heels on it. We use the same geometry block, the 105, but instead of the top two holes, we go for the heel holes on the bottom. First one I'm going to do is the right hand side. I'm going to line it up so that the first three tangs are in the index slots there. If I put this in our tower and place it on the wheel, we can verify that yes, it is where we want to put the parallel heel on the graver. For the parallel heel, I do not have the any hone rotating. I'll just put it down and swipe it across a couple of times, usually three times. Take a look. Nice, where it should be. So now I'll take it out. And if it's a little bit sticky because it's new, just use a small collet wrench to pop it out. Put it over to do the left side. And again, we'll put it down on the stone before we do anything to make sure that that's the angle that we do want to create the heel on. All right, so we have the parallel heel now on the graver. The next step might be, depending on how you're going to use the graver, to slim the graver down, to take in the right side and the left side and the top to make it a much slimmer, smaller graver. To do that, we have another geometry block. This one specifically slims the sides and top of the tool. So, in the case here of our 105 parallel, which already is made and would work fine, but I want a smaller graver. If you're going to use the slimmer, you put the graver into the top hole, the center hole here, rotate it so that the top of the graver is down, and verify that by looking at it. In this case, the first three index slots are lined up with the tang. Always good to verify by putting it on the stone and looking at it. And yes, that is the side that I did mark the Sharpie on. I want to make sure that this has the 260 grit on it. And I want to slim the top down. I'm going to put the 1200 grit finish on it so it looks nice. Now I'm going to slim down the right and the left side of the graver. So I like to do this by holding the graver upright and thinking about if I'm going to go to the right side, I would tilt it towards the right side, put that part down. And in this case, we want the direct right side of the graver facing down because we're going to slim it to make a smaller graver. The side slimming process can happen pretty quick, so keep checking to make sure that you don't take too much off. I'm going to finish with the 1200. Okay, now I'm going to take the graver out, hold the geometry block upright, hold my graver upright, and now I want to do the left side, so I'm going to turn it towards the left and insert it into the hole. Lock it down. And make sure that it makes sense when I put it on the stone. Yep. I'm going to go back to the 1200. And what I'm looking here for is symmetry, that the right and the left side are in at equal amounts. Finish up by putting the nice 1200 grit on it. I want to look at the reflection of the face in the light. I can see that the tool is well made and symmetrical from right to left. So now we have a 105 degree parallel heel graver that has been slimmed down and is ready to go. You can actually use this slimmer on other gravers as well. I didn't use it on the first graver I did, the little carbide, because it's already a very small tool. But you can use the slimmer. It comes in from the sides and the top, and it will make any tool smaller and easier to use. We developed this new engraving sharpener in conjunction with Joacim Jansson from Sweden. He has a product called the Face Fixer, and we started working with him to come up with this new engraving system. We've made this video today to give you an overview of the sharpening system. This is not a whole class in how to actually sharpen your gravers from start to finish. When I'm sharpening, I'm usually sharpening part and looking either with a loop or under the microscope to make sure that things are going the way I'm expecting and to look for symmetry and other characteristics of the graver while I'm sharpening it. So this system with these geometry blocks will take away all of your calculations of geometry, but you still have to be mindful of what you're doing and how to make the graver. And if you use it correctly and watch what you're doing, you'll have an easy, replicatable graver to make and sharpen it well every time.